Math 2, Unit 5, Solving Quadratics and Other Equations. Math is how we describe our world when words are not enough. Everyone deserves to speak math and to play math and to enjoy its beauty and its power. Jeff White. As we start this unit, use this quote to reflect on how you experience and communicate mathematical ideas. The big ideas for this unit include ideas about numbers and solving quadratic equations. In this unit, you will learn about the relationship between exponential expressions with rational exponents and radical expressions. You will learn a new algebraic strategy for solving quadratic equations. You will make and justify conjectures regarding the sums and products of rational and irrational numbers, and you will define complex and imaginary numbers. Key mathematical tools that we will use in this unit are the properties of exponents, graphs, tables, factoring, completing the square, and the quadratic formula. In the first three lessons, you'll study properties of exponents. This work builds on the exponent rules that you learned in previous courses. In these lessons, you will learn how to rewrite expressions with radicals and rational exponents into equivalent expressions using the properties of exponents. Your work in lessons 1 and 2 will help you make connections to real-world contexts so that you can discover and explain and make sense of the properties of exponents. Lesson 3 is a practice understanding task that will help you develop fluency in converting between exponential and radical representations of expressions. In Lesson 4, you will develop the quadratic formula and use it to find x-intercepts of a quadratic function. In this lesson, you will discover why the quadratic formula works and what the parts of the quadratic formula represent on the graph of the function. In lessons 5 and 6, you will practice solving quadratic equations using different strategies. You will practice using a table and a graph to find solutions of a quadratic expression, along with using algebraic strategies of factoring, completing the square, and the quadratic formula. You will also see how these strategies can easily be applied to solving a system of equations, where one equation is quadratic and the other is linear. In Lesson 7, you will practice creating different representations of quadratic functions. You will represent a function with a table, graph, and equations in standard, vertex, and factored forms. You will, however, run into a situation of trying to represent a function that does not have x-intercepts in factored form. You will start exploring the question, if the quadratic function does not have x-intercepts, is there a solution to that quadratic equation when it's set equal to 0? In Lesson 8, you'll continue your work from Lesson 7 by expanding your understanding of numbers. You will review what you've learned in previous courses regarding real, rational, and irrational numbers and how they can be represented on a number line. Your work in Lesson 7 will indicate that non-real number solutions exist when you solve quadratic equations. In Lesson 8, you will define complex and imaginary numbers. You will look closely at the quadratic formula and discover how the discriminant, the part of the quadratic formula under the radical, can give you information about the solutions for the quadratic equation. In Lesson 9, you'll explore the sums and products of rational and irrational numbers. The unit wraps up with Lesson 10, where you'll apply your methods for solving quadratic equations to solving quadratic inequalities. Here is a list of key vocabulary terms for this unit. Some of these vocabulary terms should already be familiar to you from previous units and courses. Here are some key skills needed to be successful with the content of this unit. You should be able to rewrite algebraic expressions using the properties of exponents. Factor and complete the square to write quadratic expressions in equivalent forms. Create and solve one-variable equations, and understand rational numbers. In addition to your teacher and school-based resources, there are several additional resources available. The Ready, Set, Go homework help videos are housed in the Canvas site for your class. You can access these in Canvas using your student login. If you do not know how to log into Canvas, ask your teacher for help. The K-12 Math Resources website, which can be found on your school's website, includes additional support items such as unit and lesson overviews, videos overviewing the tasks, essential vocabulary, the North Carolina standards for each unit, learning targets for each lesson, and extra practice problems.